Hi everyone. Let us see an overall view about IFRS 15. In fact, many of our clients, their finance managers, accountants were requesting to give an overall idea about what is IFRS 15 all about. Many of you know that it is effective from 1st January 2018 and it effectively replaced IAS 18 revenue recognition and IAS 11 construction contracts, the earlier two standards set by the International Accounting Standard Body. Now, why there is a need for IFRS 15? Already accounting standards are there. The recommendation, the standards in the requirements as per IAS 18 and IAS 11 in total are too general. It leads to diversity in practice. On the other hand, US GAAP, in US GAAP, the regulations were too numerous. The standard setting body wants to strike a balance between the two and at the same time address all the key issues or the address the complexities of doing business in this latest technological era. And when moving from the earlier standard to new standard, IFRS 15, there will be a change in the amount recognized and there will be the timing of recognition also will be changed. That means instead of recognizing the revenue in this year, it may move to the subsequent year, or it may move from subsequent year to this year in certain cases when comparing to the earlier standard IAS 18. The requirement as per IAS 11 construction contracts, there will not be any material changes for this construction recognition of contract revenue and all, but still there are some minor changes will be there. As the name suggests, revenue from contract with customers, the main focus for recognizing revenue is how the terms and conditions of the contracts ended with the customer, the consumer. There is a shift from transfer of risk and rewards only to transfer of control. How you will identify the transfer of control has happened? Some indicators are whether the customer has accepted the goods, whether the legal title has transferred, whether the supplier has the right to get payment, and whether transfer of risk and rewards happened, and transfer of physical possession happened. IFRS 15 suggests a five-step model for recognizing revenue. The first one is identify the contract, then identify the separate performance obligation and determine the transaction price, allocate the transaction price and recognize revenue when performance obligation is satisfied. Let us see the first step, how to identify the contract with the customer. What we have to look into a contract. The contract may be either written, oral, or implied. Okay, and in contract, two parties mutually agreed to carry out a transaction. And when the transfer of the right on goods and services transferred, how the payment terms are structured, whether the contract is a commercial in substance, is there any uncertainty for recognizing the revenue or the amount to be collected or when to collect the revenue? If there is an uncertainty, then recognition of revenue should be deferred. And in a contract, the payment terms must be clear. and the contract should be enforceable by law. The second step is to identify the performance obligation. The separate performance obligation existed in a contract. In the performance obligation, what is a performance obligation? It is a promise in a contract to provide goods or services to a customer. And another key point to note is distinct goods or services exist in the contract. Whether the goods can be sold separate or not, and whether the goods or services are interrelated or dependent, all should be checked in a contract. For identifying the separate performance obligation, let us see an example. Microsoft Corporation has entered into a contract with Hyundai Motor Company to supply the following: the license to use Office 365, you may assume maybe $100 for the same. Installation and services, including upgrading computer systems if required, but no customization of software. Technical support for 3 years. 3 years updates for Office 365. Other relevant points to be noted is Microsoft is not the only company to install and to provide technical support. Also, software can function without updates. Whether the goods or service provided to Hyundai are distinct in accordance with IFRS 15. We have to identify whether separate performance obligations can be identified. To identify whether it is distinct goods or services exist, one can see that the license to use Office 365 is separate. Even if one is taking the technical support or not, it is separately available. And Microsoft is not the only company to install and provide technical support. And the software can also update, function without updates also. In that case, these are separately identifiable. One is license to use, one is installation services, one is technical support and getting updates. These are separately identifiable, and the amount attributable has to be recognized accordingly over the period to which it relates. The third step is determine the transaction price. The transaction price is the consideration for the goods or services. Whether in variable consideration like discount, rebate or refunds exist, if there is an uncertainty, whether the uncertainty is resolved with regard to variable consideration has to be seen. Let us see an example to determine the transaction price. Lenovo entered into a contract with Carrefour, under which Carrefour was to purchase laptops at $1,000 per piece. The contract states that if Carrefour purchases more than 600 laptops in a year, the price per unit is reduced retrospectively to $900 per unit. Accordingly, the contract went on. In quarter first, the Carrefour purchases 100 laptops. So, the estimated purchase in that year would not exceed 600 laptops. Carrefour will not be eligible for volume discount. Based on the event happened, the assumption is taken. In quarter two, Carrefour purchased an additional 250 laptops. Now, the Lenovo estimates that Carrefour would exceed the threshold for volume discount in that year. Now, the total laptops purchased is 350 in two quarters. If that be the case, on an average, it will exceed 600 laptops in a year. Calculate the revenue Lenovo would recognize each quarter applying IFRS 15. Let us see. The first quarter revenue to be recognized is simple 100 units into $1,000, that is $100,000. In the second quarter, the total purchase is estimated to exceed the discount threshold of 600 units in a year, because in the first quarter we purchased 100, second quarter we purchased 250, the 350 is above average of 300 units for a period of 6 months. Then how to recognize the revenue? The total, the quarter two sales is 250 units into $900, that is $225,000, and the price reduction attributable to the first quarter sale, that is for 100 units at the rate of $100, because we are going to charge, we are going to collect only 900 instead of $1,000. Then price reduction for this 100 units is 100 into 100, that is 10,000. So the revenue to be recognized will be $215,000. The fourth step is allocate the transaction price to performance obligations, the various promises made in the contract. If it is a bundle sale, how to allocate? Okay, first we have to see whether standalone price is available, then recognize in the proportion of unbundled price, that is standalone price of each item. If there is no standalone price, then estimate the standalone price. Recognize when customer gets control of the asset. Let us see an example for allocating the transaction price. Virgin Mobiles gives its customers a free handset when they sign a 2-year contract for provision of network services. The handset has a standalone price of $600 and the contract is for $50 per month. Prior to IFRS 15, company would recognize no revenue in relation to handset and recognize a total of $600 per annum in relation to the contract. Under IFRS 15, revenue must be allocated to handset also because delivery of handset constitutes a performance obligation. Revenue is calculated as, for handset it is $600, and for contract for 2 years at the rate of 50 per month, 1200, and the total contract value is 1800. On a percentage basis, this handset value contributes 1/3, 33.33%, and the contract value is 67%. Since the total receipts is $1,200 only, it should be allocated to the separate performance obligations. For the handset, out of this 1,200, if we are allocating 1/3, it is 400, and for the contract, the remaining, that is 1,200 minus 400, and over a period of 2 years, then it should be divided by 2, that is 400. That is, in the first year, we have to recognize for handset 400 and for the contract 400. And in the second year, the remaining 50% of the contract, again, 1200 minus 400 divided by 2, 400. This should be our revenue recognition as per IFRS 15. The net effect is the revenue of $200 is moved from year 2 to year 1 when compared to IAS 18. Step 5 is recognize revenue when performance obligation is satisfied. That is, whether the transfer of control has taken place and it is at a point of time or over a period of time. That should be identified. When to recognize revenue under IFRS 15? Is any of the following conditions met? Whether the customer simultaneously receives or consumes as the entity performs, whether the entity creates or enhances an asset and customer controls it during this process. Created asset has no alternative use to the entity, and the entity has enforceable right to payment for the performance up to date. If these conditions are met, recognize revenue over a period of time, else recognize the revenue at a point of time. Let us see a small example for where contracts where performance obligation is satisfied over a period of time. Suppose that a contract is started on 1st January 2016 with an estimated completion of 31st December 2017, that is over a period of 2 years. The final contract price is US$1.5 million. In the year 2016, the cost incurred amounts to US$600,000, and 50% of the work is completed in year 2016. The certificate of work completion issued for USD 750,000, but no invoices are raised. Estimated future contract with a reasonable certainty to completion in 2017 is $600,000. It is estimated future cost. Okay, what is the contract profit in 2016? You can note that though IAS 11 has replaced with IFRS 15, the revenue recognition, the percentage of completion method is still retained, and the same can be followed after IFRS 15 also. Then the performance obligation here is satisfied over time, and the work is here, work here is the contractor performed his work, and it is for creating an asset and not for his own use and for the benefit of the customer. And there is an enforceable right to payment for work completed to date, and the contract is certified as 50% complete, and revenue can be recognized to the extent of 750,000, and the cost of revenue will be 600,000. Then the profit will be US$150,000. Since no invoice raised, there will be no receivables. The contract asset will be cost plus profit US$750,000. This is just an overall view about IFRS 15 and how to recognize as per the five-step model. Okay, what are the elements to be noted? Okay, as I mentioned, for IFRS 15, the contract terms is utmost important. Okay, same type of goods, same type of services, the contract terms may be different, and recognition of revenue will be different. And with the same customer, different terms, whether we have entered, if we have entered different terms with the same customer for different transactions of same type of goods and services, again, the recognition of revenue will be different. There is no specific method for the transaction of with the same customer or for same goods and services. It depends, it varies with the terms and contract of the entered with the customer. In future, if time permits, we can come up with some details or some specific information about identifying certain types of transactions or services and how to go about with IFRS 15. Thank you.